How's it going, everybody? It's Sean here, and I'm back today to give you guys a review of the Ruigi and Puma Suede in the Whisper White colorway. This pair is part of a greater collection between Puma and Ruigi Villasenor, better known as the founder of Rude. So alongside this low top, they also released a Puma Suede mid top as well. And this pair dropped on June 12th for $80 USD or 120 Canadian. And the official colorway for this shoe is Whisper White and Juniper. So according to Puma's website, this collection was inspired by LA youth and skate culture, and it's given that vintage touch that Ruigi's creations are usually known for. So first things first, here's a quick look at the box. This comes in this green and white colored vintage looking Puma box. It says on the top lid, "I like Puma" with the Puma logo. And then on this side, it says "Puma is quality." And on this side, I think this is German. I'm not 100% sure, so correct me if I'm wrong. And on the other side, we have that same saying in French. And then on this end, the sticker here has Puma and Ruigi co-branding. As for the shoes, so this is your Puma Suede low silhouette. Diving straight into the upper, the base layer on the toe box, this is constructed using a cream colored suede. To the touch, the suede felt like it was pretty good quality and has a nice softness to it. Surrounding the outer edge of the toe box, we have this white colored leather, and this wraps around the bottom of the entire shoe. Covering the mid panel and quarter panel of the shoe, we have more of that suede, and we have Puma branding found on the lateral side. Beneath this, we have that signature Puma stripe. This is constructed out of this green colored suede. And in the middle, to give it that distressed vintage look, we have these loose long threads, which I personally found to be a little bit strange. I think I might eventually just trim these off completely. So the green suede wraps around the back of the shoe. And on the back heel, we have this faux crocodile leather in this brown finish, along with this metallic gold Puma logo in the center. And then underneath this, there's another hit of white colored leather. For the laces, so these come with these very fat skateboard style laces. The default laces are done in this white color, but they also give you a secondary pair of cream colored laces as well. And then underneath this, we have this suede tongue. And at the very top, there's a stitch-on tag with Puma and Ruigi co-branding. The back of the tongue and the inner liner of the shoe are lined in this white colored leather. And the insole is also lined in leather. And we have Puma and Ruigi co-branding on the heel. So the upper of the Puma suede sits atop this off-white, yellow-colored rubber cup sole. It has this textured finish to it. And then flipping the shoe over to the bottom, we have your rubber outsole, which has a crosshatch traction pattern along with Puma branding in the center. So for those wondering about sizing, so I'm a true size 10, slightly on the wider side, and I feel like if you have narrow or normal width feet, you can definitely go a half size down. However, if your feet are wider, you might want to stick true to size because this is more of a narrow but long fitting shoe. So personally for me, I got these in a half size down, which is a 9.5. And because one of my feet are wider than the other, for the wider foot, I could feel a little bit of discomfort from a width perspective, but the overall length of the shoe was perfect. So I feel like if I had went true to size, the width would have been perfect on both feet, but the length would have been a little bit too long. Moving on to comfort, so the Puma Suede is unfortunately not the most comfortable shoe out there. This is a retro sneaker with very minimal tech within it, and the majority of the comfort you're feeling is coming from that padded insole. So if you're okay with a shoe that has a bit more of a firm feel on foot, and you're not looking for something with a lot of cushioning, then these are going to be okay for just an everyday casual use shoe. Finally, in terms of the overall quality and craftsmanship, all in all, I felt like this shoe was pretty solid. The material quality was pretty nice, the suedes and the leather felt pretty good, and it was definitely a step above from your normal standard GR that you'd see at a store. And in terms of the overall build on this shoe, all in all, I had no complaints. My pair seemed like it was very well put together, so I had zero issues. With all that being said, now let's lace these up and I'll show you guys how these look on feet. All in all, in my honest opinion, this is one of the best Puma collaborations I've seen in a while. I love the colors of this shoe, how it sort of has that vintage feel to it, but has that added pop of color with the green. And while I don't love the croc leather on the back, there definitely could have been worse alternatives. So let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think about this Ruigi and Puma suede. What are your overall thoughts on this shoe? Is this something you're feeling, something you would rock, or is this a straight pass for you? If you guys like this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't yet. You can follow me on Instagram at esco8. Check me out on Twitter at sean.go. and visit my website at seangoh.ca. So until next time, thank you so much for tuning in. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review, and I'll catch you guys all in the next one.